Welcome to IGM Guru. IGM Guru is one of the global leading online training and certification provider for IT expert by the skilled IT gurus to help them achieve their professional goals.
Till now, we have saw Sitecore from the content editor perspective, from the developer perspective as well. So today we have to check Sitecore capability from marketing and analytics perspective. So till now, we have saw this content editing, control panel, access management, but we have not touched anything inside here at this marketing application level. So at this place, at this side, let's go there and try to explore these features. So we already saw this experience analytics where you can check the Google Analytics kind of reports, all our static reports. So yeah, that we have already checked. Similar to this experience analytics, you have this path analyzer as well. So this path analyzer, I don't have much data inside this instance. So let me switch to some other instance here. So I have this within the path analyzer will give you that the complete flow that from where user are started their journey and which is the last page after which they exit from your website. So a user can take the different approaches to explore your website. So they can start it from home. Maybe they can end it with the about us page. Some people, they can directly start from about us and then they maybe exit from the privacy policy page. So there are different way, whatever the number of pages you have, a user can start his journey from any page. And we have saw that what are the different users who took the different journey to access your website. So this path analyzer, yeah, this is again one read-only report. So here it will show everything in the graphical manner. So as you can see here, your journey started from the center point. This is called internet. I mean, we are starting it from internet. Then from the internet, maybe let's suppose user have followed maybe this path. So within this complete path, it will show that, yeah, user has started, 45 user has started their journey from the internet. Out of 45, 27 people have landed on the homepage. Yeah, other people will go on these other branches. Out of 27 people, then two people go to this feature. Then one people will go on this about habitat feature and then they again go to this homepage. And after this, they exit from your website here. Okay, so this is the one of the path. If I select maybe this one, yeah, some people started from 45 and they come to this this page demo and then they exit from here. So one people is there. Maybe you can select this one. So here somebody started from internet, then out of 45 one people landed on this main page, on foundation, feature, register, project. So there are different pages that he has exit, and from this project page they exit from your website here. So you can see the different path here, and from this path your marketing team can analyze that, okay, which path is more popular. So the path which are more popular, you can see their branch here. So see the width of this branch. Okay, it's very broad. If you see the width of this branch, it's very narrow. So if the branch is very if your width of the branch is very broad, then it means that more traffic is going to flowing here. Okay, so more people are coming to this path or they are following this path. So this branch, the size of the branch tell you the traffic and the number of user, that how popular those branches are in your on your websites. Out of all this, somewhere you will get this red dot, somewhere you will get this green dot. It means wherever you will see this green dot, it means they on those pages we have some values. Okay, we have some values, or in other term, these pages are from the business point of view, these pages are more important. So that's why you will get something more information here, or user will get some more marketing activities here, like goals, campaigns. We'll see that, how to create those goals or campaigns. You will get the size of this circles as well. So somewhere these circles are very small, somewhere are it's very big. So if its size is very big, it means yeah, those are very important pages, or those have very high value here. Okay, so sometimes this graph is very depth. So if it's very depth, so you will see its width or its these branches, it may go at the very deeper level. So at that time you will not be able to see it. It may be something like this. So you see, if branch is very if your path is very deep, then you will get this plus sign. So if you click on this plus sign, it will again extend. So within this view, it may be possible that you will not be able to see this complete path, but if you want to see, you can change its direction. So from vertical, you can say, yeah, I want to convert it into the horizontal order. So you can see, this is your horizontal order. So now you can check that what path people have followed here on this on this complete path here. What are the different pages they exit, and which one is the last page after which they exit from your website. If you want, you can also see it into the tabular format as well. So here you can see, yeah, people have started their journey from home, then they go to the published demo, and then they exit from your website. Some people started their journey from the industries, then they go to this FAQ page, and then they exit from your website. So you'll see this different path. If you want, you can export this path into the CSV as well. So you can see, you can download it as a CSV, or you can copy to the clipboard. That is also work. If you want, you can filter it out that from which date range you want. But again, it's more useful for your marketing team. From the developers wise, no, we don't do anything here. So maybe your marketing think that, okay, maybe this path is not popular, so they make it popular. So they have a different strategy, different ideas for it. So maybe on this page, they can keep some coupon. Maybe they can keep some video. Maybe they can keep some form, ebook. Okay, and then they will share the link of this item on the social media, and people will click on this. They will land on this page. From this page, they will go here. Then they go to this one, then at the last they will go here. So the more and more people will come here, so the width of this branch will become wider and more traffic will be flow here. So if your marketing team want, they can make any path popular, and or they may intentionally divert some traffic there so that user should visit here on these pages, and some business goal they can fulfill it. So let's suppose one of the goal is that, okay, we need to collect contact detail of 100 user. So maybe on this page you will get the form, you have to fill up it. So then if more and more people are coming on this page, then this page will become popular. Again, read only, nothing adds special here for the developer point of view.
Surendra, one more question.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you go to path analyzer? Can you show the all visits what needs to be looking to do?
All visits? No, all yes. Visits. For the all visits, you should check this experience analytics. Here you will get the more good number of, good details from the visitor point of view, that for a particular duration and for particular website, how many people are visits, or this graph will helpful you for the more, rather than that path analyzer. Path analyzer will give you that which is the starting page, what are the intermediate page, and which one is the last page. But if you want to see the visit wise information, yeah, this graph will give you the more exact details.
Okay.
We have this federated experience manager, very rarely used but very strong feature. So let me give you an example for this. So let me open a new page here. So let's suppose you are working for a client, okay, and maybe they have three websites. And these three websites are in some different technology. Okay. Maybe let's suppose these are in PHP websites. These are your PHP websites. Now your client is very frustrated with this PHP website because he have to maintain different teams and more resources are going here. He need to create different databases. He have to manage it. He need the more different servers for hosting it. So now he want to move it from PHP websites to the Sitecore one. So he decided that I will move all these three websites on Sitecore, a new digital platform. So generally what we will do, we have the three websites. So we'll identify that which one is the most important website. Okay. So when you have multiple websites, so generally we will work in the phase wise. So we have the phase one. So whatever the most important website your client have, or maybe your first website, I will say. So we will migrate it to the, we will create this website in Sitecore and we will make it live. Okay. In second phase, we will take the second PHP website. And while during the development itself, okay, we are still in the development, we have not finished this development. What you can do, you have created few components here in Sitecore for the first website. Okay. So you can use components created in first website. Okay. You can use Sitecore component created in your first website here. So it's still not live, okay, this is still under development, but you can replace the component of the live website on the PHP website. Okay, your PHP website is live, so you can replace few of the component with the existing Sitecore component. Though this is in PHP website, but still you will be able to use Sitecore component on these websites here. So let's create one HTML website. Okay. So this is a non-Sitecore based website, and what we will do, we will use the Sitecore components here. So use Sitecore component. So let's quickly go there and try to create one HTML website. So what I will do, I will create one website here. Maybe I will say Z Airtel HTML website. Okay, this is the name of my website here. Inside this, I will create a simple index.html file, and inside this, I will just keep some sample HTML. So I will say, yeah, this is my HTML. Inside this, we will just keep one body. Let's make it to div maybe. And here I will say that, welcome to Airtel blog website. Blog HTML website. Here also I will create one div and say that Sitecore component render here. Okay, I have just write some random message here. So I have created this index page. I have also created this folder. Let's go there and register this website in our IIS. So I will go inside my IIS and I will add one website here. Okay. So this is the path you can provide whatever name you want to provide. You have to provide some name. Maybe I will provide www.com. So yeah, I have registered this website. Maybe you can make the entry into your host file as well. So let me go there and let me check where is my host file. Yeah. So maybe here you can register it. So yeah, my website is also registered. So now if you try to access this website, so you should get your home page here. So whatever the index page you have created, welcome to Airtel blog website. Site core component renders here. So yeah, we are good with this. Now what you want to render some site core component here. Maybe you have created your header footer, you want to render it here. So how you can do that? So for that you can take the help of this FXM. Okay. So click on this FXM. You can add your external website. So let's go there and add our external website here. So what the domain name of your website? Yeah, this is the domain name of my website. What the name? You can provide the name of this entry. Maybe you can say that Airtel FXM demo, maybe. This is the name that I am going to provide. And you will get this one line of script. This is called beacon script. Okay, you can copy this script and whatever the index page you have. So let's go there and you have this index page somewhere, maybe somewhere at last after your body, but before your HTML, you can register this script. So yeah, I have registered this script. So now if you go there, okay, what the use of this beacon script, we'll see it in a moment. So now you can save it. So the moment you click here on this save, so what Sitecore will do, it will access this website and on this website it will check do I have the entry of this script. So if it found this script, then it will say that yeah, JavaScript beacon found on the external website. So once it is fine, then what you can do, you can open it in the experience editor. So let's go there and try to open it into this experience editor. So yeah, my website is, that HTML website is open here. So it's a non-Sitecore based website, but still you will be able to access this to the Sitecore. So once it is accessible, now you can add your placeholders here. So let's go there and add your placeholder here. So where do you want to add it? Maybe I want to add it in between these two. You should provide the name of your placeholder. So maybe you can say that Airtel, PH Airtel, FXM maybe. Provide whatever name you want. Inside it, a placeholder is here. Now you can add your any component here. So you can say yeah, add here. So when you click add here, we have created lots of renderings, and within all those renderings you can add your rendering that you have added. So you see I have this header, footer, article, body. So maybe I can add this header. You can select, say select. I hope I have, yeah, so see this header component is added here. You can save it. Once you saved it, you can publish it. So let's go there and publish this stuff. So yeah, it's published. Now if you try to access your HTML website. Okay. Let's also see its index.html file. You see there is no any component here, any Sitecore component. Okay. But if you try to access this website now, so you see you are getting this header component. So this header component is now coming from the Sitecore. So this is your HTML website. Okay, but the middle component, this component, this is coming from the Sitecore. At runtime, Sitecore is managing it. Your HTML is still don't have anything from the Sitecore. Okay, but at runtime, Sitecore will inject it. If you try to see its view page source, so you see here also you will not get any any sitecore component. So it's all the magic of this beacon script. So what this beacon script will do, whenever you try to access this website, okay, this HTML website, so when this website you try to access it, it will load it on this browser. When it load, it will also load this script. So when this script will load, it will send the request to your sitecore instance. Okay? It will send this request to your sitecore instance. So this is your sitecore instance. When it get this request here, so sitecore will first check, hey, do I have the entry of this Airtel or do I have the entry of this HTML website, Airtel HTML website. So yeah, sitecore will get it inside the database. So then it will open this entry and check what exactly I have to do. So here we have write that, okay, on this we have created one placeholder, and inside this placeholder we have to load a one sitecore component, and then the sitecore component will be executed in sitecore side, and whatever the final HTML it have, it will give that final HTML to your HTML website, and then it will be rendered here. So whatever the data it have to render, it will render it through this beacon script. So this beacon script will do all this magic. As I told you, it's very good feature, but at the same time we rarely use it. But yeah, it's good to know about it.
Will it create, while doing this, will it create any sitecore related items, like any templates or?
Yeah. So you can see here this item ID. So this item ID is nothing but the its entry actually. So whatever you are going to create in sitecore, an item ID is going to be created. So somewhere in sitecore, yeah, this ID is going to be created. If you open this, or maybe if I go here and if you click on this, so now you will see this item ID. So this item ID is nothing but the item ID, a record is, or an item is going to be created by sitecore for this Airtel entries. Somewhere it will create it in its database.
You mean this feature is for updating any external website content, right? Using this feature, but not a full-fledged sitecore.
Yeah. You can use the sitecore component, the renderings that you have created. You can use those rendering, those component on external website. You can see these are the external websites. Mm-hmm.
Do we have any security related issues here, like the script, beacon script here is there, right? What if we add some placeholder, and between placeholder if we add this script in through sitecore?
No, script you have to add manually. Sitecore will not add this script. You have to add it manually here.
Then I mean, we are adding placeholders and we're adding some content, right? So what if we add in between the placeholder, if we add the script, will that work?
Yeah, see, on that rendering, finally it will be HTML. You can use any web technology. Finally, at the end of when you render anything on the browser, finally it will be CSS, JavaScript, HTML. Only these three components will be there, nothing else. So now it's all up to you, what do you want to render here? In between these two, your component can render anything. It's all up to you.
Okay.
So we are using Federated this one, right? So what is the benefit of using in sitecore? What is the exact benefit you are only using this?
See, you, as I told you, that if you have multiple website of your client and if you are migrating those website, or even if you don't migrate it, so let's suppose you have created one component. So why do you create that component? Let's suppose you have three websites and you want, let's suppose you have created one social media component. Now you want to use that component on all of your website. So once you created, why are you going to create it in every language? So let's suppose you have one PHP website. You may have an HTML website. Okay. Maybe HTML website. Maybe you have one JSP website. And now you are creating even Sitecore website as well. So on Sitecore website, you have created one component. So as you have created it, why, if you want to use that social component, then you have to create it again in JSP, again create it in this HTML, again create it in the PHP website. So it's going to waste your time. At the same time, your developer have to, PHP developer, similarly JSP developer, they have to work, then they have to do it here. Okay. They are going to again create it, so they will put their development time, testing, unit testing time, integration, deployment. So they will do all these activities. So either you can do it, or what you can do, you have created in Sitecore website, no problem. Now you can use it on all these websites here, JSP, HTML, PHP websites. So it will save your time. At the same time, you can manage that component from the single platform. So later on, maybe in future, if you want to add some more social media icons into that, or maybe you want to change something there. Let's suppose you have used the Google Plus, but now Google Plus is stopped from Google. I mean, nobody can use it. So if you want to remove it, then you have to remove it from every website. But now, as you have developed it in Sitecore, you have used the FXM. So you just need to change it here. It will automatically reflect on all these websites. So you don't need to take care of that. So it will save your time, cost, and easy for the maintenance.
Okay.
You can also create the campaigns inside the Sitecore. So creating a campaigns are super simple actually. Though your marketing team don't need your help for creating this, they can create it from their own. So, but maybe if you want, you can create it. So creating a campaign, it simply means you need it, what name you are going to provide it, maybe for which duration you want to provide it. So campaigns are generally used to aware your audience about your product, about the latest change in your business, or maybe some important news you want to share it with your visitors or clients. Maybe you want to greet them on Diwali, Happy New Year, or maybe on Christmas. So you want to run some campaigns for it. Maybe you have identify a new corona vaccination, so you want to help your client to know about it, or they should respond it for that campaign. So you can create your campaign from here. So you should provide name here, some campaign name. Maybe you can say that, yeah, Airtel new postpaid plan maybe. Okay. So you have created this. You are going to run this new campaign. Yeah, postpaid plan. If you want, you can start. You can specify some start or end date. Maybe you can say that, yeah, this plan is going to run from 16 to maybe 28. Okay. And you don't need to choose anything here. You will not get any option as well. But maybe you can say that for which channel you want to run it. Okay, so there can be a different channel. Maybe you want to run it for LinkedIn. Maybe you want to run this campaign on Twitter, Facebook. So you can choose some channel here. So maybe I will say that, yeah, I want to run it for the Facebook. Okay, so you can click here on this, that yeah, I want to run it on the Facebook. And now you can click on the save. So when you click on the save, Sitecore will generate a one campaign ID for this. Okay, so a campaign ID generated here. So now you can share this campaign ID with your marketing team. They will run a campaign here. So how they can run the campaign? So maybe they will draft one email. They can say that maybe hello XYZ user, we launch new postpaid plan exclusively for you. To know more, visit here or click here. Okay. And here they will provide some URL. So let's go there. Maybe I will try to access some URL here. airtelblog.com/articles. Maybe us. So I have just tried to access this page. So maybe your marketing team will create one button, or maybe they will create one link, and behind that link they will share this URL. Okay. Here they can say that thank you, Mr. CEO. Okay. So this is what they have provided here. And now when your user or your audience, they will get this mail. So let's suppose they have sent this mail to 1,000 users, and out of these 1,000 users, maybe 100 users have clicked on this link. So when they click on this link, so we'll get the same URL, same output, nothing change here, nothing special here. Okay. But now your Sitecore know that, okay, this user try to access this page through this campaign. Okay, so now your marketing team try to know that, okay, we have sent the email to 1,000 users. Out of the 1,000 users, how many people have clicked on this one? Okay, so how many people have clicked on this link here? So let's suppose 100 users have clicked on this. Now you want to know that, okay, 100 users have clicked here. So how Sitecore will track it? So Sitecore will track it from this URL. So to this URL we have added this campaign. So now we know that through this campaign ID, through this link, 100 users have visited on your website. Okay. How can you measure it? So you can go to your Sitecore environment. You can go to your Sitecore environment, and on this experience analytics, you will get all the campaigns detail. So you will get your campaign detail, that what are the different campaigns running on your website. So we have this 5G dongle, it's one of the campaigns. So yeah, 10 people have clicked on the link. So we got that, yeah, 10 people have visited through this campaign ID on our website. So again, your marketing team can measure the success ratio of this campaign.
Thanks for watching the video. For full course, please visit www.igmguru.com and enroll today.